I'm so impressed and so honored to be around this generation because they figured out that a career path can also be altruistic, and I can also have a career that can find ways that can benefit collectively the human body. There's one guarantee life will give you, is that your plan better be ready to be changed. I mean, my story started with my intention of being on Wall Street, and I got an internship at the Dunbar Center. And so I would say, follow your passion, but do not be dismayed if your plan seems to take another path, because ultimately, it is a path you need to travel in order to be the better person and the best person for whatever the ultimate end you'll find yourself in. If you want to get involved in public office, you need to first understand that public office is an office of service, not titles, not accolades. It is an opportunity to be engaged in a process where you can affect policy that makes life the best it can be for the residents of your city, town, village, county, state, federal government. If you have the opportunity to do entry-level work in a political office, that's great. Be a student of the policies going on in our community now. Understand them globally. We don't live in isolation anymore. And please, ensure that your passion for policy development and politics touches the ground. I always say, when we have big policy decisions we're talking about or initiatives, I said, let's make sure we taxi in. Let's make sure that the rubber meets the runway, and how is it impacting the lives of people? I give you an example, the plastic bag ban that's going on now. And so it's a very interesting conversation going on. Environmentally, it's a no-brainer. But when you begin to have a conversation about municipalities having the ability to opt into surcharges, you have to think about a city that is impoverished, and how does that affect people's ability to grocery shop, and you have a homeless population that uses those bags. So as we think about it, we're thinking, how can we get reusable bags into the hands of everybody? Because if we're going to side on one thing that helps the environment, we also need to make sure we're knowing how it's going to affect everyday folks who don't have a car, and maybe you can get the Wegmans, but they have to walk to the corner store or the neighborhood grocers when there is a department store in the neighborhood. And those bags are critical to them getting back and getting their stuff back and forth. So while we're looking to help the environment, how can we also help individuals? So as we look at reusable bags, we're brainstorming now, how can we get those into the hands of people who can't afford to buy them? Buying groceries, I can't buy a $5 bag. We have to be in government, all things to everybody, all the time.